Are you able to hear me? Okay. So a very good evening to all of you. Are you able to hear me? Good evening. Yes, I am not audible. I just now I unmute myself. So now I am audible. Yes, yes. Good evening to all of you. How are you all? Everything is fine. My voice is audible. Okay, now it's okay. Okay, good, good. I just increase the volume. Yes. Good evening, Nitya, Sanjukta. Good evening. How are you? Then we have Mansi, Sakshi, Debashish, Ankita, Arundhiti. So. Welcome to all. How are you all? Let me know, please. Yes, I am fine. I am good today. How is your day today, Arundhiti? How is your day today? Everything is fine on your side? Or it is hectic today also? Yes, Nitya, I am very much fine. Thank you. And how are you? You are good. Okay, good, good. Sakshi, how are you? Yes, Meva, good evening, very good evening. Yes, yes, Mansi, I am good, I am good. I have two sessions right before you, but I am good. So Shubh Matre is along with us. So Shubh Matre, good evening, how are you? Yes, Ankita is saying good, ma'am. Okay, very good, very good. Rachi is sending the smileys. It means she is happy. Okay, very good. Arundhiti also saying yes, today was normal. Yes, sometimes it happens. Sometimes it's, you know, very hectic and sometimes we are very relaxed. So sometimes this happens. So we have Aman along with us. So Aman, very good evening. Sakshi is also doing good today. Shubh Matre is also feeling good. That's very good thing. You are feeling good today. Yes, one of the students has just, you know, talk with me, connect with me, and then I came to know that you have to submit, you know, some report on these events which we are doing, that you have to submit the report on these lecture series. So she is asking for the PPTs basically. So I will give the PPTs today of all the biochemistry sessions which we have done until now. So I will definitely send it today, because I came to know that it is your, you know, some type of project work which you have to complete. Before it, I am not aware of it, that you have to complete it and you have to submit it to your teacher. But recently, only now I came to know about it, because first I thought it is just you want to read it or for your own purpose. But now I came to know that you have to submit it further to make a report or something. So all of you have to make this report and you have to submit it to your teacher. Please let me know. Yes, Rupal is saying good evening. Good evening, Rupal. So I think there is some students of your batch who has to submit the report basically. So for that purpose they are needing the you know, PPTs, the sessions which we have done till yet. So I will definitely send it today, all the PPTs. And you will definitely get in the group also. Yes, yes, Nitya, you have to submit the report. Okay, it is out of my mind basically that you have to submit the report also. I only think that you need it for your own study or for your, you know, to save the PPT for future references. But now today only I came to know that you have to need it for your submission basically, for a project report submission. Yes, yes, Arundhiti. That's why you all are asking for the PPTs. I am not able to get why you are asking, but now I came to know that you have to submit it to your teacher. Maybe some credits are there, something is like that. And you have also have a Viva regarding this. Oh my god, you also have a Viva. Okay, so it's not an easy job. I think it's only my duty to convey the information to you, but no, you have to pass it further. Okay, Okay, Cloris is saying, ma'am, it is for everyone. Even I don't know whether it is also there in the MBBT, because I also didn't share the MBBT PPTs with them. So yes, it's very, it's only a new thing for me. I got a call from some of you, a girl, and she told me that, ma'am, we have to submit it further to our teacher. Then I came to know that it's not only limited to you, you have also make the, you know, report on it. So definitely I will send it today after this lecture by 10 PM. I will send it today and you will get it in your WhatsApp group. Even I will try to send some more PDFs so that you will get more content to write in your project report. So no issues at all. I think some students are also from MBBT. So I will send you the MBBT PPT also, but today I will send you the biochemistry PPTs because they are present on my desktop, so it's very easy for me to send to you. And tomorrow I will send you the MBBT PPTs, okay? Because someone is also texting me, I just forget it today. As usual I forget, but I will definitely do it tomorrow. Basudha Mishra, actually some students are there who has to, you know, make the report on this 10-day lecture series, and then they have to submit it to their teachers, to their own teachers. And some, it's not for all basically, in some colleges maybe this is a criteria or something. So don't be panic, I think it's not for you, it's for some another students who already knew about it. Only I am who didn't know about it before, but now I am also aware, so I will definitely help you a lot. Okay, Aman saying we don't have to submit or make a report. Okay, Aman. Yes, there is a credit for internship. Yes. You, Sanjukta has to submit report and certify, only then I will get the credits. Okay. So this is another thing I didn't know before. So thank you, Sanjukta. Yes, Viva is for some colleges only. Viva is not for all of you, but it is for someone or in some colleges. Yes, Basudha is saying, oh, achha. Means she is understanding now. Okay, good, Basudha. So Ankita is also along with us. Ankita, good evening. How are you, Ankita? Super is here. Jeet is asking Ankita which college. Like he basically want to know in which college you have to submit the report. So Ankita, in which college basically you have to submit the report in which college? Ankita is another, Ankita is along with us. So good evening Ankita, how are you? Everything is fine, Ankita? Okay. So Ankita, Sanjay, from where basically your college is and from where basically you are? Okay, Pragya Raj. Okay. Yes, Cloris. Actually, I also talked with the Edu Fabrica team about this 30 hours. So he told me that 20 hours is a theory class, and the 10 hours for your review papers, because this lecture series will get over within this 10 days, but after it I have your review papers, I have to check it thoroughly and then I have to send it further for publications. So it's not only a 10 days journey, we have a long journey along. So that is the 10 hours are for those review papers or for those internships basically. So this is the thing they convey me. And even you can also call him or you can also contact with him, so that you all will know about it much better. And then also also share it with me. Okay, Nitya is saying Allahabad. Okay, very good Nitya, very good. Ankita Shrik saying, good ma'am, how are you? Yes, I am fine Ankita, thank you a lot. Ankita Sanjay saying, she is from Bihar basically, but her college is in Pragya Raj. Okay, Ankita. Rupal, Rupal, where are you for the last 3 or 4 lectures? I am continuously saying it that within this weekend, that is on Saturday or Sunday, you have to submit your paper, and I have only Saturday and Sunday to check your paper. Even some of you have already sent me your full review paper and I am working on it. Okay, so it's my request to all of you, if possible, kindly send your review papers by this weekend, Friday or Saturday or Sunday basically. So Shivangi is along with us. Good evening Shivangi, how are you? Deepika, how are you Deepika? So Rupal, have you selected your topic or have you sent me your abstract? Please let me know. Okay, so Chloris is saying okay ma'am, no problem. Maybe Chloris, we will be there in the bioinformatics session also, because some of you are also there in the please let me know who are there, who will be there in the bioinformatics session also. So please let me know who are there in the bioinformatics session also, because if you are there, then of course we will discuss about this review paper in the bioinformatics session also. Please let me know who is there. Okay, Rupal, if you have sent it, then it's very good. Then please keep some patience and I will definitely check it and send you back within few days. Okay, so no worries and no issues at all. I will check it definitely. I am working on the papers. I have few more papers in front, maybe in front of you. So I am working on the papers and I will send you if there is some error or something, then I will let you know. Okay, so don't worry Rupal, I will definitely check it. Okay, Aman, please don't be panicked. It's okay if you have not to write the review paper. It's just compulsory for someone, but it's not for everyone. So please be happy and don't be don't be stressed because of this review paper. Because he's saying it's not possible for us to write a review paper in short span of time. I understand Aman, I'm totally understand it. So please don't be panic, but if you are here, so just try to understand the whole process, how to write the review, so that in future if you want to write the review paper or even the research paper, so you will able to get it. Okay, yes, now he's saying yes ma'am, okay. Yes, sometimes it's happened that we are not, it's very good thing that you are querying your problem. Sometimes what happens, we are not aware of everything. So it's very good if you have any problem, then please let me know. There is no issues regarding it. We all are like friends only. There is not any teacher or student. We are just friends, and you have a full right to share your point of view, or even if you have some queries, you have the full right to share it with me. So just be happy. So this is the one thing which we have to say, that you have to submit your papers, and if you submit it to me, I will get it in my mail. Then please be patient for 2 or 3 days, because I have to check it thoroughly, and not only you, but I have many students even in your own batch. So I have to check it very thoroughly. So just be patient. I will send it back to you also. So be patient only. And yes, one more thing I want to say to all those students who have just not started any writing or something, or not doing the review paper, even it's not for those who have not started, even all of you, basically the content of review paper should be good. So the first point in the review paper is the content of review paper should be good. For getting a good content, you should at least search 9 or 10 or 20 papers at least. Now I will tell you the procedure of it again, because maybe this is skipped in this biochemistry series. I today share it with in endocrinology, so I came to know that I am not sharing it with you before. So let me share you with you. So you have to type on like Google, that Google Scholar, okay. And now the Google Scholar will get open. Now you have to write your topic, your point of interest. Like I am writing here, effect of coronavirus infection, and I want to focus on the review paper. So I write effect of coronavirus infection review. So when I search it here, you will get how many results? 1,45,000 results. So these all are the papers, and it is only the number one. On the number one page we have that much of paper, and we have 10 pages. So it's not only that you will be focused on the first page only, no. You will have to search, or you have to go through all these. From 1 to 10 you have to go through, and then you have to select the particular paper which are your point of interest. Okay, like I will open someone. I will open some PDF like this one. Effect of coronavirus infection on the human heart. A scoping review. So this paper is published in 2020, just now in this year. So this is effect of coronavirus infection on the human heart. It's a review. So this is a pattern how we are able to write the review. So here must we have to, you know, how to open a sheet. I think this is not opening in the PDF format. Yes, this is not opening in the PDF format. I will open some other one. Like from here we will open it in the PDF format. But I will open some another. Like this is a review of coronavirus infection in the central nervous system of cats and mice. Suppose this is your topic, or you are topic is related to this. So you have to open it, and you have to write, you have to read the content very thoroughly. So this is the abstract. So first of all you have to read the abstract thoroughly, and then later on you will read the whole paper. So this is the PDF. From here you are able to download the PDF also. Like I will open it here. So this is the abstract basically, and this is first published in 2008. A review on the coronavirus infection in the central nervous system. So here we have not only the paper which are in the 2020, but also the papers which are published in 2016. So you have to go through all these years, and you will have to select your particular paper. Like lithium and coronavirus infections, a scoping review. Or you can say, you also type here like effect of coronavirus infection review in India. So just let us see how much work is done in India. So if you are able to see, so this is S. Ghoshal, B. Sinha, who has done the topic is estimation of effects of nationwide lockdown for containing coronavirus infection on worsening of glycosylated hemoglobin and increase in diabetes related diseases. So I also told you very first day that you are also able to write the paper in which you are able to tell us that how the coronavirus infection is more prominent in the diabetic patient, or what is the rate of death in case of the diabetic patient and the normal patients. So this is the thing. Like here, a comprehensive review of the cross-disciplinary impact of COVID-19 in India. So this is Dhaliwal or someone who is making a review on the impact of COVID-19 in India. That is so. So this is a review of coronavirus infection in the central nervous system of cats and mice. So this is a review basically, in which we have the abstract and keywords, and then there is a general introduction. So you have to go with your particular point of interest, and you have to search the papers according to it. Okay. Then impact of coronavirus disease pandemic on gastrointestinal disorders. That how the corona pandemic or COVID-19 pandemic is affecting the gastrointestinal disorders. Okay, or you can say this one is the other side of COVID-19 pandemic, a review. Let us see how much pages are there in this review. So there are 4 pages in this review, and it is sung by Pratibha Sharma, Dr. Manpreet Kaur and Gaurav Narwal. One thing more, like if you are doing it singly or you are single author, then you are also, you know, have the right to add my name also, so that your paper will get published easily. So you will add my name also, so I will share my designation along with you, so that the paper publication process will become little bit easy. So if you are able to see here, we have abstract here, and then we have the keywords like coronavirus, environment, pandemic, and then we have the introduction of the coronavirus. So they are just saying about the related to pharma, so, or how the air pollution is affecting, or drop in greenhouse gases. So this is the way how you are able to, you can say, how you are able to collect the review and how you are able to get the content. So this is a review paper, there is not any research, there is only just the review which is taken from somewhere else, but this is the pattern of reviewing. And I will show you someone else, like this is prediction model of COVID-19 in India, rapid review. I hope you all are quite bright students, you are able to get my point. So are you able to get it or not? Please let me know. What's happening? Are you able to get it or not? So Devashish will tell you some books and no issues at all. But please let us understand the thing which I want to tell you, that instead of, you know, searching for only 2 or 3 papers, no, you have to at least, you must have 10 to 15 papers which are important to you or which are related to your topics, then you have to take the content from those topics. Are you getting my point? It's not only that by searching 2 papers you will make the review paper, no, at least you have 10 to 15 papers as a reference, and from those papers you have to take the data or you have to take the content basically. Are you able to get my point or not? Please let me know. Are you able to get it or not? I hope you are able to get it. Like this is very simple review paper. And here they are also mentioning the name of their, you know, teacher who is helping them. So that I express my gratitude to everyone who supported me and to Dr. Manpreet for the keen interest she took in me. She explained out to me solutions to the problems that had a straining effect. Without her help, it was a matter of acute impossibility to propel in this endeavor. So this is the, you know, the gratitude which is given to the teacher here, and also she is mentioning the name of Gaurav, who is maybe her along with this paper, helping her along with this paper. So it's a matter of profound privilege and pleasure to pay my sincere and heartfelt thanks to her. I am also very grateful to Gaurav Narwal who edited the manuscript. So if you are 2 or 3 friends, so you have to thank each other also. And yes, you have to add my name also. So this is all. Are you getting everything or not? Okay, Gitika, I will definitely get your I will definitely do the refreshment. So Sandhukta has some problem. She has some query. So suppose I have added references at the end of my review. Oh Sandhukta, you are not able to get it. Let me show you. But first of all, I have to find. Yes. So suppose this is my review paper. So please Sandhukta, it is specially for you only. So please be focused. because I am telling you something else and you are on some another line. I am telling you how to select the review papers and you have some another queries. So suppose this is a review of literature. So I have taken this line from someone that being serious. So being serious, test of many economically important agriculture and horticulture food crops. So I have taken the reference from Serial 1929, from Pantoja, from Halbert, from Tara and Sharma 2010. So I add their references here. Are you able to get it, or should I make it little bit more this zoom? So from where I take the references, or from where I take the line or the content, I just add the reference just by adding the bracket. Or you can also make here number like 1 or comma 2. If Cyril is number 1 in the reference, so you will add 1 or 2 also. So this is a way how you will add the references. Like we have, suppose I have take I have shown you some another things also. Wait. So this is a review paper of basically 28 pages. And I am asking you to make the review paper of 4 pages only. Or 4, not 4, 5 to 7. So this is the only references. Let me show you. Like here. So in my reference I tell basically that Gracie et al. 1998, he used a molecular marker, and this is his observation basically up to here. The author pointed out that rapid profiles for all the individuals within a species were not precisely identical. So this is the, you know, the research of the Gracia. This is not my research. This is the result which is interpreted by Gracia. So that is why I mentioned here. The author pointed out that rapid profiles for all the individuals within a species were not precisely identical. So when I am adding the someone, or when I am adding any line, then I have to add the name of the author or the name of the person from which I have collected the data. So like here I am adding the reference of Monteiro et al. 2000. Or if you will move forward to like in 2000, like this is my own paper, like Singh and Kaur 2017, compared 3 different methods for DNA extraction from the bugs. So this is how you are able to write the references. Like Zhao studied the complete mitochondrial genome. So I am just adding the name of Zhao, and then I will put the conclusion or the work of the Zhao. So this is a way of writing the reference. Or you can also write it as 1, 2. So this is up to you, but there is no need of hyperlink, or nothing is needed as such. So are you able to get it? If you are doing anything, if you are writing the line from anyone, so you have to add it as a reference. You have to mention the name of that particular author. Why we are adding the name of that particular author? Because we are giving him the importance, because we have taken, or we have used their research for our own purpose. That is why we are giving him the importance. So Sanjukta, you get it? Please let us know. So this is a most elaborate thing which I can do only. So if you are getting it now, please let me know. Even Devashi also helps you a lot. Yes, Devashi also helps you a lot. So Sindhukta is saying, "Acha, now it's clear." So now it's clear to her. So okay, good. Sindhukta, just keep it up. And it's my request to all of you, that your content should be good. If your content will not, if your content is not good, then obviously I will reject it, and we have to, you know, make it again. You have to correct the mistakes again and again. So you have Saturday and Sunday. You have 2-3 days. Don't be in hurry. Don't be panic. But just go through the review papers briefly, so that your content should be good. Are you getting my point? If your content is good, your paper is, you know, accepted by me or either by the journals, within one attempt only. But if your content is not good, if it's just a copy paste, then what will happen? You have to correct it again and again, and you have to go for major revisions also. So this is a thing I want to say to all of you, that please make your content good. So are you able to get it? Please let me know. Students, are you able to get it? Please let me know. Your content should be good. Either take 1 or 2 days extra, no issue. But your content should be good. It is from at least 15 to 20 review papers. So just let me know whether you get it or I have to elaborate it more. If you will reply me, then it will be so nice of you. Hello, are you able to get me? Yes, it's only Sanjukta who is replying. Why are not, we have 42 students along with us, but why you are not replying to me? Please reply. Yes, yes, please reply. Please, please. Yes, thank you. Thank you, Arundhati. Thank you, Floris. Yes, Megha Shiv is also here. Yes, ma'am. Okay, good, good, very good. Yes, Gayatri. Sakshi is here. Yes, yes. Actually, I forget to tell you this thing before also. It is only today when in my endocrinology section I am sharing this thing. Then I came to know that I didn't tell you about this thing before. So yes. So it's my request to all of you that content should be good. I think that's all for the review paper. I think you all are very good and brilliant students. You will definitely catch my words and you will make your paper best. Yes, one more thing I want to tell you all. Like, we have only 3-4 days in this lecture series, or you can say for this section. So it's my request to all of you that if you have some major projects for these 3-4 days, kindly hold those projects for Saturday and Sunday and just fully focused on your review paper. If you have any other activities which you must have or you definitely have, just hold those activities for Monday. And for these three and four days, like from Thursday, Friday, Saturday and Sunday, for these three and four days, kindly focus on your review paper. Just make it the best in your first attempt. Okay? Are you getting my point? Just make it best in your first attempt rather than re-correcting it again and again and again. So just focus on your review paper for these 3 or 4 days. This is my request, or you can say my suggestion to all of you, that please focus on the review paper. And after Sunday you are free, then it's only my duty. You have no duty after it. Okay? So just for these 3 or 4 days, concentrate on your review paper. So I hope you all are getting it. Yes. We have Nitya here, Shubh here, Ankita here, Prachi is also here along with us. So that's all for review section. Now we will start our next topic. So are you ready? Are you ready for it? If you still have some queries, please let me know. Otherwise we will start our next lecture. So please let me know. Everything is clear to you now? Yes. Yes, okay, good, good. So now we will start with our routines and let me check. We will start with the fat metabolism as well as with the protein metabolism. We have two things to cover today. Protein metabolism, and we have one more is here, metabolism of fat. So we will start with fats first. Okay. Yes, because in it we have less light, so we will start it with it. So is it visible to all of you? The PPT is visible. So just start, let's start. Is it visible to you? Okay, I start it. Okay, good. Good. So I will start it and then I will come in between to know whether everything is okay or not. So we have to do the metabolism of fat. Like yesterday we have done the carbohydrate metabolism, so now today we will do the metabolism of fat. So what is basically metabolism? We all know it. Metabolism of fat involves catabolic and anabolic processes. In the catabolic process, we are able to generate energy in the form of ATP. And in the anabolic process, that creates biologically important molecules. Like in the anabolic processes or in that anabolic reaction, basically we are able to get cholesterol or triglycerides, phospholipids, ketone bodies and lipoproteins. So this is the metabolism. So in the fat, when we are pursuing with the fat or we are doing the metabolism of fat, we are able to get the energy also. And we are able to get these molecules also, like cholesterol, triglycerides, phospholipids, ketone bodies, lipoproteins. So it involves two things. One is the release of energy, like in the carbohydrate metabolism also we have the release of energy in the form of ATP, and another is the release of some important biological molecules. So the pathways for the metabolism of fat. Now what happens in our body? The fat we eat helps to enjoy food and also plays an important role in our body. Fat stores helps as cushion for vital organs and protect nerve cells. So fat is used in body by two pathways, endogenous pathway and exogenous pathway. So we have two pathways. Now what happens in the endogenous pathway? That is within the body, what happens here? Mouth and stomach are the important parts in this pathway. Fat digestion begins when a gland under the tongue secretes the fat splitting enzyme called lingual lipase. So the tongue secretes the enzyme which is lingual lipase. Gastric lipase secreted by the cells in the stomach wall acts like a blender, churning and mixing stomach content. So we have enzymes in the tongue region and also in the stomach. Together this emulsifies the fat by breaking up larger fat globules into smaller ones, distributing them evenly. So what will happen? The large molecules will become smaller ones by this emulsification or by this direction of enzymes. It takes stomach longer to digest fats than carbohydrates or proteins. So higher fat meal make feed fuller and longer. So when you are eating rice, when you are eating potatoes or when you are eating carbs, what will happen? You will get hungry immediately after half an hour. But when you are taking fats as a source of energy, you are taking the fat, you will not feel hungry. It will take longer time to digest, so that is why you will not feel hungry. So then fat digestion and absorption requires the complex fat molecule covalent digestion and absorption requires that the complex fat molecules be broken down into smaller molecules. So first thing which is happening in our body when we are consuming the fat is to break the larger molecules into the smaller ones. Then we have pancreatic lipases, an enzyme secreted by the pancreas, liquid molecules into fatty acids. So this enzyme, this lipase enzyme will help us to, you know, break the fatty acid molecules. Fat does not dissolve in water, we all know it. The fat molecule enter the duodenum in a mass form which make it impossible for the pancreatic lipase enzyme to attack them, since lipase is a water soluble enzyme and can only attack the surface of the fat molecule. So we have the pancreatic enzymes which are there. Then we have the gallbladder. These all are enzymes of the intestine, or you can say these all are the digestive enzymes basically. Then bile is produced in the liver and stored in the gallbladder. So bile is produced in the liver, but where does it get stored? In the gallbladder. So this one is the gallbladder, the green one. So which enters the duodenum through the bile duct. Bile emulsifies fats. So this is the important one, that bile emulsifies the fat, means it disperses them into small droplets. So large molecule of the fat will be broken down into small droplets, which then become suspended in the watery content of the digestive tract. Emulsification, kindly remember this word, emulsification. Emulsification allows the lipase to gain easier access to fat molecules and thus accelerates their breakdown and digestion. What happens during emulsification? The lipase enzymes, kindly concentrate, during emulsification, the lipase enzymes, they will break the fat molecules into the smaller ones. So lipase and other digestive juices break down the fat molecules into fatty acids and glycerol. So this is the thing which is happening inside our digestive system. Then after it, absorption of fat into the body, which takes 10 to 15 minutes, occurs through the villi-like finger-like projections. So these are the finger-like projections which cover the walls of small intestine. So in the intestine, so this is the intestine. So we have the finger-like projections here. Like we have the finger-like projections here. Inside each villi is a series of lymph vessels and blood vessels. These vessels absorb the fatty acids and glycerol into the lymphatic system, which eventually drains into the bloodstream. So they are telling us how the, you know, there is a digestion of the fat in our own body, how it from starting from the mouth, the enzymes which are there in our mouth, then we have in our stomach, then followed by this intestine, and then we have the absorption and transportation of the fat. Now what will happen? We are able to break the fat into the smaller molecules. These smaller molecules are now absorbed. These fatty acids are transported by the bloodstream to the membrane of adipose cells. So where the fat gets stored basically? In the adipose tissue, or even in the muscle cells where they are stored or oxidized for energy. So the fat in your body, they are either, you can say, transported basically to the adipose, they are stored basically in the adipose tissue as well as in the muscles also. So fat is the body preferred source of energy, and since only about 5% of absorbed fat can be converted into glucose. So only 5% of the fat is used only, rest 95% of the fat is remain as such in your body. So they are saying that only 5% of the fat can be converted into glucose, which can be used as a source of energy. A significant proportion of digested fat is typically stored as body fat in the adipose cells. So that is why it's very difficult to lose our fat, because it gets stored in the adipose cells. Even if we, by some crash course, by some dieting, even if we are able to lose our weight, but when we start eating, what will happen? We are gaining the double weight. Why? Because of these four processes. Only 5% of the fat is dissolved or gets break into glucose. Rest will remain as such. So the glycerol part is absorbed by the liver. We have already done about the fatty acids or lipids, in which we have the glycerol molecule along with it we have the three fatty acids attached. That is why they are known as triglycerides. So the glycerol part is absorbed by the liver and is either converted into glucose. So glycerol gets converted into glucose by the process of gluconeogenesis. What is gluconeogenesis? When we are able to get the glucose from any other substance instead of glycogen, and used to help in the breakdown of glucose into energy. So only glycerol is used, but the fatty acids change, they remain as such. So this is again the absorption and transportation, the same which we have done. This is again the same thing. Kindly read it by your own self. It is the same thing. So this is a fat metabolism. This is how the metabolism is occurring in our body. So we have adipose tissue in which we have triglycerides, these yellow ones. So with the help of enzyme lipase, which is present in our digestive system, with the help of enzyme lipase, we are able to break this triglyceride into fatty acid and glycerol. This glycerol molecule will be used as a glucose, and further it is used for the production of ATP or energy. This fatty acid, are you getting my point? These fatty acids will be utilized in the oxidation, or you can say beta oxidation of fatty acids. So beta oxidation stops when fatty acid is completely degraded and converted into acetyl coenzyme A. So these three fatty acid chains, as you remember, we have CH2OH and fatty acid attached, CHOH fatty acid attached, CH2OH and one fatty acid chain attached. So these fatty acid chains will get changes into acetyl coenzyme A, which will enter in the TCA cycle, which we done yesterday, and then we are able to get this ATP. You are able to get from this yellow one, we are able to get the ATP, the amount of energy, or you can say energy which is used by our body. So this is endogenous pathway. Are you here? Everything is okay? Let me check it, then I will proceed. Yes, it's visible. Okay, good, it's visible. So I am just proceeding, then I will came back again. So this is the whole fat metabolism, that from this fatty acids which we have along with glycerol, this glycerol will change into glucose with the process of gluconeogenesis, which we have done yesterday. Yes, with the help of gluconeogenesis, and this fatty acid cycle or the beta oxidation will continue how long? Up to that it is completely converted into acetyl coenzyme A, which is there for TCA cycle and also for the electrotransport chain, and by it we are able to get ATPs. So this is the endogenous pathway. So liver is the main organ which helps in the fat metabolism. So you have to remember one thing, for the metabolism of your fat which is there in your body, there are five main types of lipoproteins which are involved in the digestion, or you can say for the proper utilization of the fat molecules. What are these lipoproteins? They are chylomicrons, VLDL, LDL, HDL, three fatty acids. Yes, I came to know, I already provide you some homework. During our lipid section, I asked you to tell me the difference between LDL and HDL, and no one of you, remind me this question. So again, this question is now for you. You have to tell me the difference between LDL and HDL, and which one is good for us and everything. Okay, so tomorrow you have to answer this question. So this is the liver. The liver is able or is helpful in basically fat metabolism, and there are five types of lipoproteins which are present, which are chylomicrons, VLDL, LDL, HDL and three fatty acids. Every cell needs cholesterol, so liver continuously produces VLDL. LDL are having decreased density of protein and increased density of lipids. HDL, which is high density, go around body interacting with other lipids particles in cells and picking up stray cholesterol. So you have to tell me about all these LDL, VLDL, HDL, okay? So tomorrow you have to be along with it. So when cholesterol becomes oxidized, it becomes sticky and stagnant over artery walls. We all know about this condition when we have high amount of cholesterol in our body. So cholesterol becomes sticky and just it is there in our artery walls basically. So in the bloodstream, macrophages help in keeping the dead particles and debris out. So if artery walls are diseased, more macrophages try to keep the endothelial intact. So if the wall is filled with this cholesterol, so what will happen? The foreign particles are able to attack us more. So VLDL becomes degraded as they pull over various aspects of cholesterol and may result into LDL. So this is LDL basically. What LDL do? You have to tell me yes tomorrow. I will not show it here right now. So this is the thing what happens in the bile, or you can say liver, what the functioning of liver basically. So liver start producing free fatty acids. From where the liver able to get the fatty acids? Because it's a digestion, it's a whole point or the whole part of the digestive system. So liver are able to get the free fatty acids by the pancreatic lipases. We are able to get the fat molecules, the small fat molecules. So these free fatty acids, then they will pass into the fatty meal, passes in the duodenum and bile, emulsify the fat. After the emulsification of the fat, what do you mean by emulsification? When we are able to break down the fat molecules. Now the fat molecules, the larger for fat molecules become smaller ones. Now after emulsification, what will happen? More soluble fibers form as a gel, and the gel binds itself with the bile salts. Gel holds those bile salts and take them in intestine and excrete through the feces. So basically what will happen? We will able to utilize this as a energy. Like during starvation, when we are on a fasting mode, what will happen? These adipose tissue, which has a lots of amount of fat stored, they will release only 5% of the fat, which is utilized as a source of energy. So by complete oxidation of 1 gram of fat, by 1 gram only, we produce 9.3 calories energy, whereas carbohydrates give us only 4 kilogram. So per gram, 4 calorie per gram. So fat give us 9.3 calories and carbs gives us only 4 calories. So this is again the digestion part, that in the stomach we have fat come, and then we have the gallbladder here, which will definitely release some enzymes. Then the fat further passes here. So first, bile salts emulsify the fats in small intestine, forming mixed micelles. Then intestinal lipases degrade triacylglycerol. So basically the only thing which you have to remember, that after all these processes, what will happen? We will able to get the triglycerides. We will able to get the fatty acid side chains only, which will be further used or for the ATP production in the form of beta oxidation. So I will show you somewhere. So these are the micelles, that how the fat molecule will become there. They will change their shape for the during emulsification basically. I have to show you one thing. Let me. They are showing the digestion in the, or the absorption of fats, or the breaking down of the fats in the intestinal region. I have to show you something. These are the finger-like projections in the intestine, in the small intestine. We already discussed it before, that in the intestine we have the finger-like projections, which are quite helpful for the proper breaking down of the fat molecules. So in the liver, fats are changed into phospholipids. So the blood leaving the liver contains both fats and phospholipids. These phospholipids, such as pyrimidine and lecithin, are necessary for the formation of nerve and brain tissue. We already discussed it before in the lipids series, that pyrimidine, they are necessary for the activity of the brain. So lecithins are involved in the transportation of the fat to the tissue. Cephalin, another phospholipid, is involved in the normal clotting of the blood. So they are just the fat in the excess of what the cell need is stored as adipose tissue. So they are just letting us know about the functioning of the fat in our body. It's not only that we are able to get energy only, no, they have many another functions also, like they are there in the nerve and the brain region, they are involved in the normal clotting of the blood, so they are involved in the production of heat and energy. So these are the function of the fat molecules. So now this is oxidation of fats. This is the basic thing, which is the most important thing we have to do. What do you mean by oxidation of fat? In which there is oxidation of the molecule, oxidation of two products of hydrolysis. So we have oxidation of glycerol and oxidation of the fatty acids. So glycerol and fatty acids together makes the triglycerides. Remember it. Glycerol and the fatty acids, they are making the triglycerides. So basically it is oxidation of the triglycerides. So oxidation of the glycerol, because why we are naming it two, because during the digestion process there are pancreatic enzymes, there are bile juices there, and even in the liver we are able to break the fat molecule into small molecules, and the fat molecule gets broken down into glycerol as well as the fatty acids. So we have different oxidation for glycerol as well as for the fatty acids. So oxidation of glycerol is metabolized through the carbohydrate sequence. First of all, lipids get changes into glycerol, and this glycerol will obviously follow their own pathway, which is basically known as gluconeogenesis. Remember the thing which we done yesterday, when we are able to get glucose, or we are able to get glucose from the source other than glycogen. So this is gluconeogenesis. So this is the thing, same the thing which we have done before, that we have acetyl coenzyme A which will enter into the Krebs cycle or TCA cycle, and there is a release of lots of energy. So this is the oxidation of glycerol. This oxidation we have already done in the yesterday's topic, that is in the carbohydrate metabolism. Our main focus is on the oxidation of the fatty acid, the three fatty acid side chains which are there along with the glycerol molecule. So our main focus is on these three fatty acid side chains breakdown, because glycerol is definitely gets converted into glucose by the process of gluconeogenesis, and from glucose we are able to get acetyl coenzyme A. The acetyl coenzyme A will enter into the TCA cycle, and there is a production of lots of energy, or you can say ATP. But what will happen in case of these fatty acids? These fatty acid molecules are also converted into acetyl coenzyme A, but how? By beta oxidation of fatty acids. So these fatty acids will convert it into acetyl coenzyme A, which will further, you know, utilize in the TCA cycle for the production of energy. So we have to read, or we have to understand the beta oxidation, in which the fatty acid molecules are converted into acetyl coenzyme A. Getting my point? Our main motive is to release acetyl coenzyme A from the fatty acids, either from the glucose, either from the glycerol, either from anyone, because from this acetyl coenzyme A we are able to get the energy in the form of ATP. So there are several theories about the oxidation of the fatty acids. The original one proposed by Moop in 1905 and still preferred today, the beta oxidation theory. It involves the oxidation of the second carbon atom. Remember why it is known as beta instead of alpha? Why it is known as beta? Because the oxidation is occurring at the beta carbon. So we have one functional group. The carbon along the functional group is known as the alpha carbon, and the carbon next to the alpha carbon is known as the beta carbon. So it involves the oxidation of the second carbon from the acid end, beta carbon, and so it removes two carbon atoms at a time from fatty acid chain. This is an 18 carbon atom oxidized into 16 carbon atom, then this 16 carbon atom gets oxidized into 14, and it will continue how long? Until we will break the whole fatty acid chain. If you able to remember the lipids class, I told you that we have 18 carbon fatty acid chain, 16 carbon, 12 carbon, 20 carbon. So there is a long chain of 18 carbon like stearic acid, linoleic acid, palmitic acid, oleic acid. So there may be 16 carbon, 12 carbon, 18 carbon. So what will happen here? During oxidation, only two carbon atoms are removed and the whole rest long chain will be there. So from 18 we are able to get 16 chain. From 16 after oxidation we are able to get 14th long carbon chain, and from 14th oxidation we are able to get the 12th long carbon chain, and so on. So this section will continue until the oxidation is complete, until the whole fatty acid chain gets broken. So this is the beta oxidation. So before starting this beta oxidation, let me know whether you are getting it or not. Everything is fine. So yes, by one acetyl coenzyme A, we are getting 12 ATPs. In the carbohydrate metabolism, we already discussed this thing that we are getting the 12 ATPs by one acetyl coenzyme A, and in TCA cycle we are getting 36 to 38 ATP. But here in this fat, in the fat molecules, we are able to get 96 ATPs. Like we are able to get here from palmitic acid, we are able to get 96 ATPs, and one molecule of palmitic acid total gave us 129 ATPs. That much amount of energy is given by fat. So that is why fat is not bad for our body. It's very good for our body, but if it is consumed in a limited amount, if you will take it in a large amount, definitely it will cause us lots of problems. But if we are able to take it in a limited amount, then it is very good for all of us. That's why I also told you in the previous session that kindly add 1 spoon of desi ghee in your food, because it's very good for your mental health, for your brain activity, and even some vitamins are consumed only, or you can say absorbed only, when there is a fat present in our body. It is especially for the girls also, that please kindly proceed or kindly eat desi ghee or eggs maybe, for your, but eggs are a source of protein and fats as well. So please try to eat desi ghee in your diet. So this is the amount of energy we are able to get it. And these are the amount types of lipids which we have already discussed. We have triglycerides, we have waxes, sphingolipids, ceramides, sphingomyelins, phosphatidyl, ethanolamine, phosphatidyl serine. These phospholipids we already discussed in our lipid section. We already discussed glycolipids there. So I will not do this again. I just want to, now these are the enzymes. You have to remember the name of enzyme, like langual lipase, the very first enzyme, gastric lipase. They all help in the breakdown of the fatty acid molecule. This is again the digestion in our stomach. So by this triacyl, yes, this is the glycerol. So we have CH2OH, CH2OH, CH2OH. So this is the fatty acid site. And what will happen? We are able to get the fatty acid. This is only single fatty acid, but we are able to get all the three fatty acid molecules plus one glycerol. So this glycerol will further used for the, this glycerol will further converted into glucose. I hope there is something somewhere. So here this glucose will get converted into glucose, and we are able to get energy. And these fatty acid chains are break down up, or there is oxidation of these fatty acids until the whole chain gets oxidized, and we are able to get lots of energy. Now what is the role of fat in gastric emptying? Fat delays the rate of emptying of stomach. Action is brought about by the secretion of enterogastrone. So they are telling us about the activity which is there in our digestive system. This is again the same diagram. This is the functioning of chylomicrons, VLDs, LDLs. So I have just asking you about LDLs and HDLs. Like this is carry about 70% of total blood cholesterol, and HDL basically removes excess cholesterol from the body cells. So we will discuss it tomorrow. Now we have lipolysis. What do you mean by lipolysis? From the name, it's obviously when there is a breaking down of the fat or splitting of the fat stimulated by epinephrine, norepinephrine or cortisol. So cortisol is again a very important hormone. I asked you this question, what's the function of this cortisol hormone? But I didn't find any reply yet. So this is again the question which I will ask you tomorrow also. So this is the thing, that this is the triacylglycerol. By the combination of glycerol and fatty acid, we are able to get the triacylglycerol. But we have to break this triglyceride into the monoglyceride, so that we are able to get the fatty acid molecules. This is known as lipolysis, when we are able to break this chain and these fatty acid molecules are freely movable. And this glycerol which is left, this glycerol, it is consumed in the form of glycolysis, and the fatty acid chain, like this lipid, is broken down into two things, glycerol and fatty acids. This glycerol, this pathway we have already done yesterday. Our main focus is on this pathway, that how from fatty acids we are able to get the acetyl coenzyme A. This is the path of carbohydrate metabolism we already done yesterday. Today we will done only fatty acid to acetyl coenzyme A. Yes, so we have to do beta fatty acid oxidation. But before it, let me know whether you are present or absent. So are you getting it, or my voice is okay or not? Deva, she has so much knowledge. Okay, so are you getting it? Everything is fine. Are you getting it? Are you feeling okay, or are you feeling bored? Please let me know, because it's a very easy thing. Even we have one lipid section before also. We have done the lipids, the structure of lipids before also. So that is why I am doing it little bit fast. I hope you are able to understand it. So is it clear to all of you? Yes, yes, please let me know. Is it clear to all of you? Okay, so you are getting everything. Very good. So I will just focus on beta oxidation now, because this is a very important thing in case of fat metabolism. Then after it, we will move forward to the protein metabolism. Okay, good. Thank you all. So now we will move towards our this thing, which is beta oxidation of the fatty acids. Yes, I hope, yes, it's clear. So we will move towards the beta oxidation of the fatty acid. What happens in beta oxidation? So the end product of E cycle is a fatty acid shortened by 2 carbon and acetyl coenzyme A. So if you have 18 carbon fatty acid chain, what you will get? You will get 16 carbon fatty acid chain and one molecule of acetyl coenzyme A. Getting my point? If you have 16 carbon long fatty acid chain, what you will get? You will get 14 carbon chain plus one molecule of acetyl coenzyme A. So the series of reaction is also known as beta oxidation pathway, because the major reaction site is a beta carbon. Okay, and it happens in the mitochondrial membrane. I will show you in the pictures also. So this is the cytoplasm. This is the cytoplasm, the blue one. And from here we have the mitochondria starts. So this is the outer membrane of the mitochondria. This is the inner membrane of the mitochondria. In between the outer and inner membrane, we have intermembrane space. Getting my point? And what we want basically, we just want acetyl coenzyme A. From where we want this acetyl coenzyme A? From this fatty acid. So are you able to see the pathway? That from the cytoplasm we have to enter in this membrane, then one reaction is there in the intermembrane, and from this intermembrane we will cross the inner membrane, and then we are able to get the acetyl coenzyme. Getting my point? From this cytoplasm, from this fatty acid chain, we will enter in the outer membrane. Then some reaction is there in the intermembrane. Then we will pass from this inner membrane, and then we are able to get the acetyl coenzyme A. So let's see how it happens. So this is basically the beta oxidation in which we are able to get the, at every stage we are able to get the acetyl coenzyme A and two carbon less fatty acid chain. I just want to start the reaction. Yes, this is the four steps of beta oxidation. This is the overview which I already told you. This is the overview. Now let's start the reaction. So number one step in the beta oxidation is the dehydrogenation of the fatty acid acetyl coenzyme A to make trans double bond between alpha and beta carbon. So what happened basically in the very first step here, from this fatty acid chain we are able to get fatty acetyl coenzyme A. From the fatty acid chain, what will happen? Coenzyme A attach with this, basically acetyl coenzyme A, in the presence of enzyme acetyl coenzyme A synthetase. So with the help of this enzyme, acetyl coenzyme A binds with our fatty acid. Getting my point? So we are starting from this fatty acetyl coenzyme A. So what happened here? Dehydrogenation of fatty acetyl coenzyme A make a trans double bond between alpha and beta carbon. So between alpha and beta, why this is known as beta carbon? Because it is attached with the alpha carbon who has functional group attached. So the carbon with functional group is known as alpha carbon, and the carbon with alpha carbon is known as beta carbon, or the carbon after the alpha carbon is known as beta carbon, and the carbon after the beta carbon, that means this carbon, is known as gamma carbon. So alpha, beta and gamma, but we are mainly focus on the beta carbon. So what happens in the first step? We are able to get the double bond between alpha and beta carbon. So if you are able to see here, in between this CH2 CH2, we have now double bond. Getting my point? That between this alpha and beta carbon we have the double bond. So short, medium and long chain acetyl coenzyme dehydrogenase E remove transfer to FAD. So we are able to get the double bond in the first step, which is dehydrogenation. What do you mean by dehydrogenation? Removal of the hydrogen basically. So by, if there is a removal of hydrogen atom, so we have double bond here. Now number two is hydration of the double bond. Now what happens? We add water. In the presence of enzyme, enoyl coenzyme hydratase. Now what will happen? If we are adding water, what will happen now? This CH becomes CH2 again, and the OH will attach with the beta carbon. Getting my point? We have in H2O, we have H and we have OH. So H will attach with the alpha carbon and OH will attach with the beta carbon. So this is known as hydration of the double bond. Now what will happen now? After it, dehydrogenation of the beta hydroxyl group. Now this group, the beta carbon, now what will happen? Dehydrogenation will occur. What do you mean by dehydrogenation? Removal of the hydrogen atoms. So the hydrogen atoms will be removed and there is a double bond. So we will get C double bond O. Getting my point? First we have, it is CH2, but we are now, by these three steps we are able to get C double bond O. Now what we will do? We will add coenzyme A. So we are adding the coenzyme A in the presence of enzyme coenzyme A acetyl transferase. What will happen now? This coenzyme A, what it do now? Let me show you. This coenzyme A will bind again. So this molecule will break from here. This is CH3C double bond O HCO. So this is the alpha carbon. This becomes separate. It becomes acetyl coenzyme A. This becomes separate, and the rest chain is of 14 carbon. First the chain is of 16 carbon, but now the rest chain is of 14 carbon. So we have again the first structure which is there. We have same structure here, but with two carbons less. Getting my point? We have the same structure which is there in the first step. This is, but this is 16 carbon. But on here, when after these four steps, definitely the structure is same, but with 14 carbon. So two carbons are used as a acyl coenzyme A, which will be further used for the energy production. Are you get it? I will show you another pictures also. I have another also. So we will able to get 146 molecules of ATP from this 18 carbon. So from this 18 carbon, we are able to get 146 molecules of ATP. So let me show you again. Yes. So this is the process. We have three steps in beta oxidation. Please remind these three steps. These are quite important. We have dehydrogenation, in which there is a removal of hydrogen atom. The number one. Here, the removal of hydrogen atom is there, and what will happen? We have the double bond in between the alpha and beta carbon. Then the number two is addition of the water, that is hydrogenation. What will happen by the addition of water? The double bond will break and we have the OH group attached. The number three is again dehydrogenation. By again dehydrogenation, this COOH group will change into C double bond O. So what will happen here? We have dehydrogenation, we have hydrogenation, again we have dehydrogenation, and then the last is cleavage. So when we have dehydrogenation, what will happen? We will have the double bond in between alpha and beta carbon. By hydration, what will happen? We have the OH group attached here. Not OH, I think double bond O. So we have the, by hydration we have the, yes, OH group attached here. And in the third step, what will happen? So in the third step, this hydrogen will remove and we have C double bond O. I'm sorry for this writing, but it is only the cursor. So this is the four main steps in case of beta oxidation. Are you able to get it? Let me show you again. Yes. This is acyl coenzyme A. From here we start, basically from acyl coenzyme A. So this is the thing. Not here. Here. So this is the thing in dehydrogenation. First of all, we have the double bond between alpha and beta carbon by the process of dehydrogenation. Then we add the water. Then there is a formation of COOH at the beta carbon. Then again there is dehydrogenation. Then what will happen? There is C double bond O at the beta carbon. And when there is a cleavage, what will happen? The molecules will break down into two parts. So this is the alpha carbon, which is attached with the functional group. Then we have the beta carbon. Then we have the gamma and omega. So we have lots of carbon. This is again the same thing. Everything is again the same. You have to focus on alpha and beta only. So we will forming the bond between, the double bond is between alpha and beta. Then after it, there is attachment of OH group when we are adding the water. Then after dehydrogenation, there is C double bond O. And then there is a breakage of this molecule and the acetyl coenzyme A. So the alpha carbon will separate from the beta carbon. So with this process, from C14 we will get acetyl coenzyme A, and 14 gets changes into 12, 12 gets changes into 10. So on. This reaction will continue until we are not getting the last acetyl coenzyme A. So this is the way of acetyl coenzyme A production. So this is the amount of energy which we are getting from the 16 carbon fatty acid chain. 131 ATP. We are able to get 131 ATP. It is too much large as compared to the another carbohydrate metabolism. Okay. So this is the, again the same thing is this. and then this acetyl coenzyme cycle will enter into the TCA cycle and we will get some another extra energy also. So this is the main thing basically. Let me check. Are you able to get it or not? Are you able to get it? Beta oxidation is the only thing which is there in case of your fat molecule. If you are able to understand beta oxidation, then your this topic or metabolism is complete. So are you able to get it or not? Please let me know. Okay. Even I have one video of this beta oxidation. If you want to, I will share it with you. It is of 8 minutes. So let me check.
Oxygen consists of a long chain of carbon and hydrogen atoms. Now we
I will share the link. You will just see by yourself. Okay, I'm just sharing the link, so please go through it by yourself. If you want, I will show it to you also. So go through this link. Basically this is the beta oxidation of fatty acids. Even if you want to, I will play it here also, but I think it's no need of it to play. Then this is
body triglycerides,
the animation of the fatty
reactions
acid.
Liver. Later, it gets phosphorylated into glycerol 3-phosphate by all the tissue.
If you want, then I will play it also. No issues at all. But I think you will watch it by your own self. So should I play it or is it okay? I think it's okay. So are you able to get the oxidation or the beta oxidation of the fatty acid? It's very important. If it is in your syllabus, if this part of biochemistry is in your syllabus, then beta oxidation is definitely in your exam, because it is that much important. Then we have protein metabolism along with us. So just start little bit about the protein metabolism and then we will conclude the protein metabolism tomorrow, but we will start it today. Okay, we will start little bit today. Let me check the smaller one PPT. Yes, I will start with this today. So we will do, today we will do a little bit about protein metabolism and we will conclude it today. So are you getting it or not? Please let me know first. Please let me know, are you getting it? Then we will start protein metabolism. Please reply, then we will move further. Ankita, Anishri, Arundhiti. Okay, so we have one more presentation on the protein metabolism. So I am just going to show you something about proteins. And we will conclude, or we will wrap the proteins today, tomorrow, not today. Because then it will become little hectic for all of us, okay. So I am just going with the proteins, general PPT, or some parts of protein metabolism. Yes, so protein digestion or protein metabolism. For protein metabolism, first we have to break down the protein. Like for fat metabolism, we have to break it into smaller molecules. Similarly here, we have to break it down in the stomach. No protein hydrolyzing enzymes are found in the saliva. So in the saliva, we don't have any type of enzymes for the protein breakdown. Like for the fats also, we have some enzymes in our tongue, but this is not in case of protein. So hydrolysis and denaturation is done with the help of pepsin enzyme and HCl acid. produce short chain polypeptides in the stomach. So this is a very important point, that protein digestion starts in the stomach. Like carbohydrate metabolism starts in our mouth, fat metabolism starts in our mouth, but protein digestion starts in the stomach. Why? Because saliva has no enzyme for proteins basically. So the digestion of proteins occur in the stomach. So hydrolysis and denaturation by pepsin enzyme and HCl acid produce short chain polypeptides in the stomach. We have trypsin, chymotrypsin, carboxypeptidase enzymes which are helpful in the digestion of the proteins. And then we have aminopeptidase from the cells in the small intestine. They are also helpful in the digestion of the proteins. Now what will happen when we are digesting the protein, when we are breaking the protein? We are able to get polypeptides, and from the polypeptides we are able to get the amino acids. So three amino acids are absorbed through intestinal wall by active transport, enter bloodstream and are brought to cells. The total supply of three amino acids available is called the amino acid pool. So the total amount of amino acid which is available is known as amino acid pool. This is a journal summary of the digestion of the protein molecule. So it is not started in the mouth because we don't have any enzyme. It will started in the stomach. In the stomach we have HCl enzyme and the pepsin enzyme. They will break or you can say denature the protein. Then after it, by the stomach, the protein gets changes into long polypeptide chains. After further hydrolyzation in the small intestine, in the presence of enzyme trypsin, chymotrypsin, carboxypeptidase, aminopeptidase, we are able to get amino acids. Getting my point? So from the larger protein molecules we are able to get polypeptides, and from the polypeptides we are able to get amino acids, and then these amino acids are moved into the bloodstream. So this is the digestion or the breakdown of the protein which is occur inside the digestive system basically. Now we have two terms, transamination and oxidative deamination. In case of proteins, like in case of fatty acids we have beta oxidation. In case of proteins we have transamination and oxidative deamination. What happens in these two steps? There is the degradation in the amino acids. Remove alpha amino group, break down and process carbon skeleton. So release of an amino group is generally by transamination and oxidative deamination. So if you are able to see here, so we are able to release the amino acid in the bloodstream. But how? So let me show you how. These are the amino acids, alanine, aspartate, glutamate, glutamine. They are present in higher concentration in the mammalian cells. So alanine, aspartate, glutamate, glutamine, they are present in the higher concentration. They have some metabolic function as well as some role in protein. So glutamate is the most important metabolically active amino acid. So some transaminases are also used for diagnosing the disorders. So these are the another like enzyme. We have alanine aminotransferase. They help in escape in large amount from dead or dying liver tissue. Then we have aspartate aminotransferase. So we have different enzymes which are here for the, you know, for the breakdown or the for the formation of amino acids. Yes. Now what's transamination? What do you mean by transamination? Trans means transfer of something, if you are able to get it from it. So most transaminases share a common substrate and product with the enzyme glutamate dehydrogenase. So we have an enzyme glutamate dehydrogenase, and we have two products, glutamate and oxoglutarate. So what happens? This permits a combined excretion pathway for the individual amino acids. transdeamination. Glutamate has a central role in the overall control of nitrogen metabolism. Let me show you one diagram. So what will happen in case of deamination? What will happen? Like we have glutamate here. In the presence of enzyme glutamate dehydrogenase, we are able to get alpha-ketoglutarate. This is oxidative deamination. Then again, glutamate dehydrogenase will reversely convert this glutamate to alpha-ketoglutarate and alpha-ketoglutarate to glutamate. So this is the reversible reaction. From glutamate, we are able to get the alpha-ketoglutarate. Then we have urea cycle. What happens in the urea cycle? This is only the demonstration. This is only the general demonstration. I will do it briefly tomorrow in the next protein PPT. So what happened here in the urea cycle? Ammonium salts, which is NH4 positive, they are toxic compounds. So oxidative deamination, converting glutamate to alpha-ketoglutarate, is easily shifted equilibrium reaction. So ammonium ions building up the favor for the synthesis of excessive amount of glutamate, decreasing the Krebs cycle intermediate alpha-ketoglutarate. This in turn decreases the ATP production and that affects the nervous system. I will show you in the cycle what they are saying basically. So we have glutamate. The inputs to the urea cycle are ammonia, CO2 and aspartic acid, and the outputs are urea, ADP and fumaric acid. Yes, so this is the basically the urea cycle. That from ornithine, this is the one molecule, in the presence of enzyme carbamoyl phosphate, we are able to get citrulline. And from this citrulline then move into the cytoplasm, and this citrulline changes into arginosuccinate. Ornithine gets changed into citrulline in the mitochondria. So this is the mitochondria, the blue one is the cytosol. From citrulline it gets changes into arginosuccinate. From arginosuccinate it gets changes into arginine, and then it again changes into ornithine. So ornithine gets inside the mitochondria, and citrulline they just get out of the mitochondria into the cytosol. So during this reaction we have the release of urea, which will move out of our body. So this is a basically the protein metabolism, and even we are using the amount of energy here also. So you have to remember one point: ornithine will move inside the mitochondria and changes into citrulline. This citrulline will move out of the mitochondria and changes into arginosuccinate. This arginosuccinate will change into arginine, and arginine will change into ornithine. So ornithine will move inside the mitochondria and changes into citrulline. Citrulline move out of the mitochondria and changes into arginosuccinate. And during this process we are able to release the urea. So this is the thing. Ornithine changes into citrulline. Citrulline changes into arginosuccinate. It changes into arginine. And when arginine changes into ornithine, there is a release of the urea. So this is the thing, that there is a release of the urea, and even there is a citric acid cycle which is also associated with this urea cycle. So fumarate from the urea cycle enter the Krebs cycle. So from here fumarate will enter into the Krebs cycle. Aspartate produced from oxaloacetate of the Krebs cycle enter the urea cycle. So basically both these cycles are interconnected, but you have to remember only this thing, that how ornithine will change into citrulline will change into arginosuccinate, and arginosuccinate will change into arginine, which will release urea. This is the only thing which you have to remember in case of urea cycle. So we are able to get the urea basically. Let me check. So like in humans we have urea, in some aquatic species we have free ammonia, which is released from the gills. So we have the free ammonia which is released through the gills, and tertially produce urea, because still needs very water for removal by kidneys. So spiders excrete guanine molecule. So this is excretion. Reptiles and birds excrete uric acid. Okay, reptiles and birds. But basically urea and urine is released out of the body. So concentrated urine super saturated with uric acid goes into the cloaca. Concentrated urine and super saturated with uric acid goes from the cloaca into hindgut. Uric acid crystallized and water is reabsorbed. So this is the, in humans what happens, uric acid deposit even in our toe or even in between the fingers, and this situation is known as gout. So this is the basically the overview that how we are able to fate of the carbon skeleton of 20 amino acids, that these are the amino acids which we are able to get by protein digestion. We are able to get alanine, we are able to get glycine, we are able to get cysteine. So this is the fate of all these amino acids, that how they will come under the TCA cycle, because their only destination is the TCA cycle, then how they will come inside the TCA cycle. Okay, so this is the destination of all the amino acids. How we will get the amino acid? By the digestion of the proteins we are able to get polypeptides. Further digestion or further breakdown of protein polypeptides, we are able to get the amino acids. So this is the amino acid biosynthesis. How we are able to manufacture or synthesize amino acids. I think that's all in this series. So our main focus is basically on the urea cycle. So are you able to get it or not? Just concentrate on, like in the fatty acid, the concentration, or you have to focus on the beta oxidation. In the proteins, you have to focus on the urea cycle. So are you able to get it or not? Please let me know. We have some slides or some PPTs of
actions in
your protein.
All the required amino acids. Each cell has a characteristic collection of protein.
So I will say this. So are you able to get it? Please let me know. Okay. So I think that's all for today. We will meet tomorrow with lots of another positive energy. And yes, I will try to cover it tomorrow. Everything related to your biochemistry. Tomorrow is what, basically? Thursday. And on Friday we will take your last session, which are basically the virtual labs only, in which we have to check the gel electrophoresis PCR. So I will try to conclude it on Thursday and Friday. So today is Wednesday, we have 2 days more along with us. So please be there along with me. We have 2 days more, and then this lecture series will be over, and I will try to cover everything within these 2 days. So is it clear to all of you? Everything is fine? You are getting it properly? Please let me know. Yes, I am hoping that all of you are getting it. Yes, good. It's very good if you are getting it. So if you have any query, please let me know. Otherwise, I will just share the PPT with you now. Otherwise, I will forget it again. So that's all from my side. I wish you all the best for your project submission, for everything, for your review paper also. Yes, Tanmay is also here along with us. How are you, Tanmay? Vishali is here. Nitya is here. Gayatri is here. So we will meet again on tomorrow with lots of fresh energy. Till then, take care of yourself and please like my videos. It takes lot of effort to make videos, so please like it and also subscribe to my channel. Vishali, where are you in the beginning of the lecture? Actually, for half an hour I am only on the review paper. So I am asking you again and again that please be there even in the starting of the session, because important things we discuss in the starting of the session. So Vishali, you have to submit it within this weekend, either on Saturday or on Sunday, okay? Yes, yes. So this is my request or suggestion to all of you, that kindly go through beta oxidation of fatty acids and urea cycle. Please, today or even tomorrow also, before the lecture, kindly go through the beta oxidation of the fatty acids as well as the urea cycle of the protein metabolism. They are very important. Okay, Tanmay is fine. Okay, good, Tanmay, good. Take care of yourself. So that's all from my side today. We will meet tomorrow. Till then, take care of yourself. Good night. Vishali, are you able to get the answer? So you have Saturday and Sunday. So just be ready with your review on Saturday or Sunday. Yes, so that's all from my side. And I just wish you all the best for your future projects. So take care of yourself. Good night. Bye bye. We will meet tomorrow. Bye. Bye Ankita. Bye Jeet. Bye Omkar. Okay, welcome Omkar. No, no, no Vishali. Why are you saying sorry? Please don't say sorry. No issues at all. You can ask me how many times. It's your wish. No tension at all. Okay. So it's Vishali. Good night. Arundhiti. Good night. Take care. Sakshi. Bye bye. Good night. So we will meet tomorrow. Till then, take care and just go through beta oxidation and the urea cycle. Okay, bye Ankita, bye. So that's all. And today I will share the PPTs before with all of you, or even with one or two, they will put in the group and you all will get it. Okay. So bye, bye bye to all. Take care. Okay, good night, bye bye. So I am now going to do end stream. We will meet tomorrow. Okay, bye, bye Debashish, bye. From where you are getting these smileys? Let me check. From here. Yes, yes, from here. Bye bye to all. Yes, okay. From here you are getting the smiley. Take care, we will meet tomorrow. And this is a buffering. This is a buffering. Okay. So yes, okay, we will meet tomorrow. Till then, take care. How to minimize it now. Okay. Yes. So that's all from my side. We will meet tomorrow. Okay. So take care.